You're not going to want to miss this episode of the AI Show, where we talk about language, we talk about recipes, and we tie it all together with search. Make sure you tune in. Hello and welcome to this episode of the AI Show. My name is Seth Juarez and I have a special guest today. Tell us who you are and what you do, bud.
I am Luis Cabrera. I am a program manager in the Azure Search team.
Fantastic. So tell us, Azure Search, but special. I've heard of something called cognitive search.
Right.
We might have done some episodes, but why don't you fill us in on what that is?
That is right. So Azure, the cognitive search part of it has to do with the ability to enrich information so that you can search this information. And you actually did an AI show on the knowledge store.
That's right.
Recently, so now we're going even beyond search scenarios. So actually, in the screen right now, you can see like several parts of the pipeline. Mm-hmm. You can see how we take data from a variety of data sources. Then we say document cracking. We essentially know the format of different file types to be able to extract their text, their images. We can read different data sources. We can also read structured data sources such as databases, whether they're relational or not relational. So then we apply machine learning algorithms, AI algorithms, mm-hmm. that we call cognitive skills, to the information. Sometimes, let's say that you have some customer feedback, you may want to do sentiment analysis on that information. Or maybe today we'll be talking about how we can translate some information as well. So essentially, you can apply different machine learning models to the information to extract a tree of information that is then projectable into either the knowledge store, or you can project it into the search index so that you can query it.
So let's slow down and let's bring this image back up, because I've been having to work on a demo for this.
Yes.
I ran into some things that I have some questions. So let's get this screen up and let's ask a little bit, because here's the thing that I want to ask. The first thing is, okay, so this is for searching.
That is right. Okay. So Azure Search will index your information so that you can quickly retrieve the data.
Got it. And so
that said, people told us, look, this is super valuable. Once you enrich this information, like, I really, really like that you extracted essentially structure of what was unstructured data. Can you please share that structure with us?
Got it.
And that enables other scenarios beyond search, such as analytics or machine learning.
Got it. So the first thing I ran into is this notion of, okay, so if I were just to do regular Azure search, there's this thing that happens called document cracking, and you see it there.
That is right.
So what does that actually mean? What are you doing to the document mm-hmm. when you're indexing it?
Think of a PDF. Okay. Let's say that it's a contract, Very valuable contract. You know, like, if you can find this contract, that's $1 million difference,
right?
Whether you can find it or not, or amend it or something like that. And guess what happens? This contract, it's a PDF, and inside the PDF, there are just a bunch of images. So you need to extract the text out of those, for instance. So the first thing that we do as part of document cracking is we say, is there any text in that document? Because sometimes they have structured text.
Okay.
Think of a Word document that has both images and text. So we extract the text, and we say, are there any images embedded in this document? So we can extract the normalized images as well.
I see.
And that means that we have to understand not only PDFs, but PowerPoints, Word documents, a bunch of different file formats.
So what's happening is, because we understand a bunch of file format, and this is before we even get to the AI bit.
That's right.
We have to crack this document open and be like, mm-hmm. here's the text, here's the images, here's what other things do they crack open?
So really is the text and the images and some metadata. Sometimes there is metadata on the file themselves.
Like how old the file
is. The title. Sometimes, in a PDF, you can have a title field, for instance. Or the timestamp of the file. But sometimes you can also put metadata about the file, not in the file itself, but let's say in blob storage. You can have additional columns. Mm-hmm. So we also know how to read those.
I see. Yeah. So even not even getting into the cognitive part, you basically take the document as it's indexed, you crack it open, here's the text, here's the images, here's some metadata, and now we can do glorious stuff with AI to make that even more intelligent.
Exactly.
Okay.
Exactly.
Cool.
That's
cool.
Exactly what we do.
That's awesome. And so when we do that, I mean, how hard is it to do this?
Well, I'm going to show you that it's a very, very easy path that you can follow without writing a single line of code.
Okay.
So today we are going to, I'm going to show you a scenario where Sometimes you need to translate content. Imagine you have a Swedish company, right? So all your technical documents are written in Swedish, and then it turns out that your company just went global.
Right.
And now you have support centers in Mexico, in Brazil, in Denmark, and guess what? Or here in the US. Yeah. And these customer support representatives may do a query, not in Swedish. They don't know Swedish.
Yeah, I don't.
So they would type English most likely, right? So wouldn't you want all your technical documents to be translated to English before,
right.
before
and you can search? Obviously very costly. But AI has made it a little bit easier.
Yeah. Right. It should be super easy because we have all the AI models.
And what I mean by costly is having humans translate stuff
that
is ridiculously expensive.
That is right. Yeah. And the time also. Imagine having to hire all kinds of people that speak Swedish. Right?
That's right.
Yeah. So I have a problem closer to home.
Okay. Let's hear
about it. So I'm Hispanic. You're Hispanic as well.
We are both Hispanic.
Okay. And I moved to this country pretty early. And then when my kids were born, my wife didn't speak much Spanish, and my kids didn't learn Spanish.
You know?
Shame on me.
Camera two here. I am the same. My wife is really mad when my kids don't speak Spanish. So we will hang our head in shame after this episode on behalf of all of los hispanohablantes.
That's right. Yeah. So now, there is one thing that is harder to lose than language.
Right.
Which is, you know, this wonderful food that we cook. My mom comes and grandma cooks all these amazing meals.
Yes, right.
And then when she leaves, the kids are like, oh, we love that dish that grandma makes. And then we're like, which one? The one that has chicken
that's
and
right,
sauce.
That's right.
They don't even know what the name of the dish is. So my mom is amazing. Mm-hmm. And she said, you know, Luis, no problem. I'll make a recipe book for you.
Okay.
So she, you know, started the, you know, she gave me a ton of pages of different recipes because she wants her, you know, legacy to continue
right.
on.
That's right.
At least the food part of it.
Yeah.
So I thought, oh, wouldn't that be great for my kids to be able to search these recipes, to find the recipes that they care about? So it's exactly the same problem.
Right. It's exactly
so,
the problem.
So, all right. So if I am going now to the Azure portal, you can see my blob storage account, and you can see that I have all kinds of images that I downloaded, and that's an example
of. But they're all in Spanish.
Yeah. I mean, she put the ingredients and everything. That's some kind of eggplant right there. So I already put this in blob storage. I'm going to go to my search index, and there is this beautiful import data wizard. So I'm going to click on that. I'm going to say that I want to index a blob storage account because I already put it somewhere. I'm just going to select it. And I believe I put it in one that is called Luis Castor. And I called it multi-lang because it has different recipes in different languages. Okay, so now I'm just going to give it a name. I'm going to call it my recipes. And I am going to add cognitive search or skills, AI skills, to enrich my information. So right now, the system went to blob storage, understood what kind of data I have there in order to tell me what enrichments I can apply to this information.
And so for those that are wondering and looking at this, for once you crack the document, enrichments are things that you can add to either the text, the images, or the metadata,
exactly.
Or all three of them, so that the tree then gets bigger.
Bigger and bigger.
Bigger
yes.
and bigger,
yes.
And then you can search on more things. Okay, cool.
Exactly. So now, just a few technicalities. I do need to attach a cognitive services resource. That's so that I can actually get billed for these capabilities. Mm-hmm. So I selected a resource, the customer demos cognitive services resource that I had created. This resource has to be in the same region as your Azure search.
Which makes sense, right?
You don't want to be sending data across regions.
Else.
Exactly. And now we get to add all these enrichments. So I'm going to say, let's OCR the content because I know that the content is just a bunch of scanned images that she sent over email. And that's going to create a merge content field. So what does that mean? It looks at the file. If there are images inside it, it extracts the text out of it. If there is text in the file, it will also use that and merge it together into one single big field that has text.
So in this case, if you have information and images, even in like a Word document,
yeah.
then it will be able to find the doc text as well as the text in the
image. That is correct. Okay, cool. Consider technical documents that have diagrams and things like that. Okay, so now I can apply all kinds of cognitive skills, but today I'm going to just do one of them.
Which is that's new, because I haven't seen that one before.
That's new, exactly. So this is the new translate text skill. Mm-hmm. You can call it programmatically as well, but today we'll do it through the portal. And I can tell it what language to translate it to, because this presentation is in English. We'll just keep the English language. And it's going to put that in the translated text field.
So which is another part of the
another
tree.
Another node in that tree of enrichments that you were talking about. And that's all I'm going to do. Just for awareness, you could project that into the knowledge store. There is an AI show just for that, so I am not going to go into too much detail there. And then I can click next to customize the target index.
Okay.
This will allow me to select the different fields that I want to have in my search index. And in this case, for instance, you will notice that I have my translated text, and I want it to be searchable and retrievable. There is one text here, layout text, that has all the x, y coordinates for each of the pieces of text. I don't need it in this case, so I'm just going to remove it. One more thing that is interesting in the translated text, it automatically, because I told it the language of the translation, it automatically picked the English analyzer for it.
That's cool.
So we can do better indexing given the knowledge of the language. There are two English analyzers here. There is the Microsoft and the Lucene analyzer. Why do we expose both? So the Lucene one is faster. The Microsoft one is better.
Okay.
So like one is richer than the other. Let's do the Microsoft one in this case.
And it's always a trade-off whether
it's
you want
speed or... It's always a trade-off. Yeah. Exactly. So we figured we will offer both of them.
So for those that are watching, because you mentioned two terms that confused me initially, indexer and an index.
That's right.
An index is like a table that's going to store all this stuff.
That is right. The index is what you actually will query at some point.
Got it.
Right? So think of it as having, yes, it has certainly the information about the different fields. Internally, it's structured in a way that is optimized for fast queries.
Right.
The indexer is really what connects the data source, the skill set or the enrichments, and the index together.
I see.
This is the orchestrator.
It's like
that
the workhorse.
Yeah, exactly. Go to get data from the data source, document crack it, enrich it, and then push it into the index.
That's the construction worker of the actual search, because it has its tools, which are the skill sets.
Exactly.
It bangs on the data that comes out, and then it puts it in the index.
That's a fair analogy.
I love it. Okay.
Okay. So, all right. Perfect. Now that we have that, I'm going to give my index a name. I'm going to call it recipes. Okay. And I am going to create the indexer or this orchestrator. I can tell it whether I run it hourly or daily or at some custom schedule, because sometimes I may have like millions of files, right? So I can say like, once a day, just check what's new and then update the index. And I'll call it this the recipes indexer. And I'll click submit. So I have, I don't know, less than 100 files here. So it shouldn't be, it shouldn't take too long. So actually, it's going on right now. It will probably take about a minute or so.
Uh-huh.
But just to save time while we are doing this,
sure.
I have the recipes index that I just created, and I have the cook recipes
index. The cooked one.
They pre-cooked ahead of time.
That's awesome.
So let's just go to the indexes, and I have the cooked recipes here.
Nice. We're going to run out of analogies here pretty soon.
That's right.
Yes.
So okay. So let's say that we're searching for chicken recipes, and you can see that there is some kind of eggplant, and then the procedure, and you can see the text in Spanish. So I was able to find the berenjena recipe, even though the text was not in English in the beginning.
That's cool.
So I am hitting right now the index directly, so you can see, I'm essentially making a request on the index. And you can see the translated text and the score for each of them and so forth.
Right.
I want to make you aware of one more thing, because usually you will not show this in just a REST call, right? So there is a solution accelerator that we have put up for you. if you go to aka.ms/kmsolutions, and this solution accelerator has many capabilities. It can teach you how to create custom skills, but it also has a web UI template.
Okay.
And that web UI template, it's a small application that has a little front end. And essentially, I just modified my app settings.json, where you can put, let me make this a little bit bigger for you, essentially a set of credentials there of your storage account, your service, the key to hit the service, and so forth. And then run it already so that we can see what happened. I believe I have it right here. So I can.
So this is a nicer way of querying the index, so it looks better.
It's nice to visualize the results, just to kind of connect the scenario end to end here.
Cool.
So let's say I'm searching for recipe. Let's say I have some beets in my fridge. Let me make this just a little bit bigger. So I'm gonna search for beets. And so for instance, it will show me my mom's enchiladas right here that have. Beets. It turns out that Guatemalan enchiladas have
really. Beets. I had no idea.
They're delicious.
I'm like learning cultural and technical things.
That's right.
This is awesome.
Okay, so in retrospect, what did we do? We learn a little bit about cognitive search. Mm-hmm. We learn about this new skill, the translate skill that makes it. We didn't write a single line
of
code.
That's right.
And makes it very easy for me to find technical content, and we also learn how to visualize that. If you use the solution accelerator.
Well, that is fantastic. This has been pretty cool for a number of reasons. Number one, because I love Spanish and I should teach my kids Spanish. Number two, because we saw some cool recipes. And the thing that was new, because we kind of learned a little bit about this stuff before, but the thing that was new for me is that little checkbox that has those extra skills to do the translation, which is really cool.
That's right.
All right. Well, where can people go to find out more?
So you can go to aka.ms cognitive search.
Fantastic. Yeah. aka.ms cognitive search. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for watching the AI show. If you have any questions or comments, we'd love to hear them. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time. Take care.
Thank you. Bye-bye.